Hello friends, welcome to Yogic and Modern Science. Friends, today let's move on to the next sutra of Shiva Sutra. The next sutra is, I think this is the fifth sutra of the third part. The fifth sutra says, Nadi Sanghar Bhut Jai Bhut Kevalle Bhut Prithakkani. It means the destruction of channels, victory over the elements, detachment of the elements, and separateness of the elements. That's all. Now Lord Shiva is talking about the destruction process, the destruction mode of the jeevatma or the conscious agent. In the previous episode or in the previous sutra, we had explained how the jeevatma gets into the destruction mode. Because these three powers are inherent in the jeevatma. Jeevatma has the power to create, to maintain, and to destroy also. Now, we need to understand what is actually destroyed or what is the actual meaning of destruction, because nothing is destroyed. Okay, this is the golden rule. Nothing is destroyed. So what is the meaning of destruction in terms of the jeevatma? So in order to understand that, we need to understand how or what is the meaning of creativity or creation by the jeevatma or by the conscious agent, or how jeevatma creates something. Okay. Now, the development of the jeevatma starts with getting the sense of its own existence. Okay. So this is the first development of the jeevatma itself. It means jeevatma get centered with this feeling of its own existence. So this is the first step towards the development. Further, the jeevatma gets desire. Okay. And then so many different types of desires. In this way, the jeevatma develops its mind or man. So firstly, it gets the sense of its own being, then it develops its mind by its desires, so many desires, and then these desires create the vital energy or prana shakti. And due to the mind and the prana shakti or the vital energy, it is able to link to various units of the prakriti or various elements. And due to the linking with the various units or various elements of the prakriti, it creates its own system, or you can say it creates its own body. So this is the process of creating a body, creating a system. Okay. So firstly, it creates, it develops its mind, then vital body or vital energy or prana shakti. And from the vital energy, it links with other elements. Right? And those other elements, okay, they have also got the vital energy. Otherwise, linking is not possible. Right? Now this is the process of creation. Then it maintains its own creativity, and then it gets into the destruction mode, when elements are separated from the jeevatma. Now Lord Shiva in the sutra is talking about this process of destruction. How the jeevatma gets detached with these elements. Now, getting detached with all these units, with all these elements of the prakriti, is the destruction of the destruction by the jeevatma, or destruction of the body of the jeevatma. Okay, so when jeevatma gets into the destruction mode, then what is the process? Okay, this needs to be understood very clearly. Friends, in the previous episode, I had told you the dynamism of the three eternal elements. Okay, in the mool, or in the original nature, okay, what is happening? You see, the energy of consciousness, it is around the whole prakriti. But when we observe the dynamism of the energy of consciousness around the prakriti, then at the top it stops. Then again it takes round to the whole prakriti, then again it stops. So this is stopping of the energy of consciousness. It is there at each and every level, in the prakriti also. At the level of the whole prakriti, at the level of a big creation, at the level of our own body, at the level of the body of any animal made up of one cell, unicellular elements. Means from minute to the largest body, big body. This formula applies everywhere. For a human body also, we have also the energy of consciousness for this whole body. So, in the process of destruction, at the end point, what happens? When our energy of consciousness stops, it is indicated by the stopping of our the movement of vital energy. The movement of vital energy stops, or prana shakti stops. Lord Shiva is saying nadi sanghare. So with the stoppage of this prana shakti, the elements which were linked to this prana shakti, they also get separated, because now prana shakti or vital energy is not working. It has stopped. With the stoppage of this vital energy, the other elements which were attached previously, now they get detached. They get separated. So this is how the destruction of the body, or separateness of all the different elements of the body, takes place. So what is important is the stopping of that energy of consciousness. This is very important to understand. Lord Shiva is saying nadi sanghare. Nadi means the minute tubules through which energy or vital energy flows. Prana shakti, the energy of prana, or the vital energy, flows through these nadis. They are not visible in our physical body, but in our subtle body they exist. And through these channels, through these nadis, okay, which are 72,000. So through these nadis, the energy of prana or the vital energy flows. So with the stoppage of the movement of this vital energy, there is destruction of these channels or these nadis, right? And then the elements get separated. In this way, the body of a normal human being, okay, is said to be died. And the jivatma with its desire and the non-moving vital energy, okay, it departs from there. Okay. Now, further, what happens to that jivatma, we will talk about it in further sutras. Okay. But in these sutras, the Lord Shiva talks about very clearly, very elegantly, how the body of the jivatma gets destroyed, means all the elements which were attached to the jivatma through this vital energy or through these nadis, how they get separated. So in the further episodes, okay, we'll be talking about further the